Oh, it's the abdomenless one. Poor thing. Some bird had a good day.
3, 2, 1, action.
Hi, I'm John LaPola. I'm an entomologist here at Towson University. And today we're going to talk about periodical cicadas. So come along. In any given year, there are broods emerging somewhere. It's just that this one, brood 10, is one of the is the largest. There's three species altogether. What's called the pharaoh cicada, people call it the one we're hearing in the background. They make like a pharaoh sound. So only the one species, the pharaoh cicada, is the one that forms the big choruses. Yeah, this is the Cassini. You can tell because it's all black abdomen here. That's the call saying, please don't eat me. Don't taste good. You see that silvery part? That's called the timbal membrane. And that's actually what vibrates that makes the sound. And this part of their abdomen is largely hollow. This is the pharaoh cicada. This is the one we're hearing. And see how this one has orange striping? The other one was all black. It's one of the ways you tell the species apart. The males sing. It's easy to tell the backsides. The females are pointy because it's the ovipositor on the back. This is like the love song of the cicadas, right? And so they're all mating up in the trees. And then the females will land up here and then on thin branches, what she'll do is she'll poke her ovipositor and lay eggs in there. The eggs will be in these little branches and they'll sit for about 6 to 8 weeks and then they'll hatch. And then the little nymphs are about the size of a grain of rice. They're bright white and they'll fall out of the trees, go down into the ground, and then they won't emerge for 17 years. So this is the emergence holes, right? So they were about a foot underground. And then this year, through mechanisms that are not entirely clear, they hit the 17th year and they began digging up probably in April. That's why I was saying the rain last night probably really flushed a lot of them out. This is just the old exoskeleton that they hatch out of. That stringy white stuff that you always see, that's actually the air, that's how they breathe. So this is the trachea, which when they molt, they actually molt that system out too, which is what all that white stringy stuff is. A cooler spring will sort of delay their emergence a little bit, but at some level, at some point they just have to emerge. This is the end. They're only going to live a few more weeks. Yeah, so people estimate there's about 1 million cicadas an acre. There are 3 17-year species and there are 3 13-year species. Having that long span makes it really hard for predators. They can't track them as a food source because they just come up so infrequently. There is one parasite that does track the periodic cicada, that fungal pathogen, Massospora. When this nymph emerged, it became infected with this fungus. The fungus actually lies dormant for 17 years. This individual will fly around and infect other cicadas. There's drama occurring in your backyard. You don't have to go to Africa or Asia or South America to see amazing things. And you know, the periodical cicadas are just a really good reminder of that. There's nowhere else in the world where you get this sort of phenomenon. You know, as we go about our busy lives, it's really easy to miss that we're part of nature and that what happens to biological communities is going to impact us. The world would be fine if humans disappeared tomorrow. The world would go on. If insects disappeared tomorrow, the terrestrial realm would collapse overnight. It just couldn't function without insects, from pollination to recycling nutrients and all those kinds of things that we just don't think about them very much. These little things that run the world, right? Then we're just sort of reminded of it.